creation cry, God, we praise you. Oh, we praise you. Oh, watch the giants fall, for fear cannot survive when we praise you. A lot of breakthroughs on our side, forever lift you high. With all creation cry, God, we praise you. Oh, we praise you. Oh, we praise you. Oh, we praise you. Oh, we praise you, God.
Yes, Lord.
Hallelujah. Yes, Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise you, Jesus. Yes, amen.
Hallelujah. I keep thinking of that verse that says, no weapon formed against us will prosper. Amen. God is the God of breakthrough. So he's breaking down those walls. Whatever you need this morning, my God shall supply all our needs according to his riches in Christ Jesus. Hallelujah. You know what? We just need to get it. We just need to go get it. Let's go get it this morning, amen? Let's get all that he has for us today. He wants to break down every wall. Hallelujah.
Who breaks the power of sin and darkness? Whose love is mighty and so much stronger? The King of glory, the King above all kings. Who shakes the whole earth with holy thunder? Who leaves us breathless in awe and wonder? The King of glory, the King above all kings. This is amazing grace. This is unfailing love. That you would take my place. That you would bear my cross. You would lay down your life. Set free. Oh, Jesus, I sing for all that you've done for me. Jesus. Who brings our chaos back into order? Who makes me orphan, a son and daughter? The King of glory. The grave. Worthy is the Lamb who was
worthy.
This is amazing grace. This is unfailing love. That you would take my place. That you would bear my cross. You would lay down your life. That I would be set free. Jesus, I sing for all that you've done for me. Oh, thank you, Jesus. Oh, we praise you, Lord. Worthy is the King who conquered the grave. Worthy is the Lamb who was slain. Worthy is the King who conquered the grave. Worthy is the Lamb who was slain. Worthy is the King who conquered the grave. Worthy is the Lamb who was slain. Worthy is the King who conquered the grave. Oh, we worship you, Lord. We praise you, Jesus. Yes, Lord. We give you glory. We give you glory. Yes, Lord. Worthy is the Lamb who was slain. This is amazing grace. This is unfailing love. That you would take my place. That you would bear my cross. You would lay down your life. That I would be set free. Jesus, I sing for all that you've done for me. This is amazing grace. This is unfailing love. That you would take my place. That you would bear my cross. You would lay down your life. That I would be set free. Oh, Jesus, I sing for all that you've done for me.
Hallelujah. Praise you, God. Hallelujah to your name, Lord. Thank you for your faithfulness, God. Thank you for your love, Lord.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord.
Praise you, Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, God.
We just thank him this morning. Thank you.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank the Lord
thank
this
you,
morning
Jesus.
For what he has done for
thank
you.
Thank you so much
what he
for
has
our
done
salvation,
for us
Lord.
As
thank
a people.
You, Jesus.
Thank you, Lord, for your great love and your great mercy, Lord.
Hallelujah.
Your loving kindness, Father, that are yes. new every morning, Father.
Thank you, Lord.
We receive that today,
yes,
Lord. We
God,
receive
we
that,
receive
Father.
It, Lord.
Even as you just pour down upon your people today,
yes.
God. As we're here to worship you, Father, no matter where we're at, Lord, you know exactly what we need. You know exactly, Father, the cry of our heart today. So we thank you, Jesus, that we can say that we know that we belong to you, Father. We know that we belong to Jesus. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
By that the highest King would welcome me. I was lost, but he brought me and oh, his love for me. Oh, his love for me. Whom the sun sets free,
Oh, he's free indeed. I'm a child of God. Yes, I am.
Free at last, he has ransomed me. His grace stands deep.
While I was a slave to sin,
Jesus died for me.
Yes, he died for me. Who the Son sets free. Oh, he's free indeed. I'm a child of God. Yes, I am. In my Father's house, there's a place for me. I'm a child of God. Yes, I am. Forsaken, I am who you say I am. You are for me, not against me. I am who you say I am. I am chosen, not forsaken. I am who you say I am. You are for me, not against me. Oh, he's free indeed. I'm a child of God. Yes, I am. In my Father's house, there's a place for me. I'm a child of God. Yes, I am. Forsaken, I am who you say I am. You are for me, not against me. I am who you say I am. Oh, I am who you say I am. Yes, I am who you say I am. The sun sets free. Oh, he's free indeed. I'm a child of God. Yes, I am. In my Father's house, there's a place for me. I'm a child of God. Yes, I am. There's a place for me. I'm a child.
are chosen.
That's right.
You're chosen. He chose you. He chose you even before the foundations of the earth.
Amen.
He chose you and you and you. Thank you,
That's
Jesus.
Right. You know, I love that verse. Whom the Son sets free is free indeed. You know what? That's something God did.
That's right.
That's not something we did. That's something God did. God broke the chains. He broke the lies. He broke the deceptions. He broke the sin and death. That's something God did. The devil will try to lie to you and say, oh, well, you're in bondage, or you're this, or you're that, or you're this, or God doesn't love you, or you're not accepted. Those are lies.
That's right. Yes.
Whom the Son sets free is free indeed. All I got to do is accept it and walk in it.
Amen. Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
I'm so happy for that.
Amen. Amen. I think we ought to say, I am free indeed.
I am free indeed. Yes.
Hallelujah.
Of
the goodness of God. All my life you have been faithful. All my life you have been so, so good. With every breath that I can hear, I will sing of the goodness of God.
Your goodness is running after, it's running after me. Your goodness is running after, it's running after me.
If my life laid down, I should render now, I give you everything. Your goodness is running after, it's running after me.
Your goodness is running after, it's running after me.
Your goodness is running after, it's running after me. If my life lay down and surrender now, I give you everything.
Your goodness is running after, it's running after me.
All my life you have been faithful. All my life you have been so, so good. With every breath that I am able, I will sing of the goodness of God. All my life you have been faithful.
All my life you have been so, so good.
Every breath that I am made, I will sing of the goodness of God. I will sing of the goodness of God. Oh yes, Lord, you're good, Lord. You're so faithful, Lord. You're so good, Lord. Oh, you're so good, Lord. Hallelujah, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Praise you, Lord. Praise you, God. Praise you, Lord.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus.
Oh, Jesus, thank you that you pursue us, Father. Thank you, Lord, that you don't leave us, God. That you don't forsake us, Father. That you walk with us, Lord. Many times you have to walk ahead of us and we have to catch up with you, but we are so thankful, Lord, that your goodness runs after us as your people, Jesus. We just open our hearts to receive all that you have for us today, Lord, knowing, God, that your goodness goes before us. It makes a way for us, Lord. We must be obedient to that call, Lord, that you've placed in our hearts and in our lives, Lord. Obedient, Father, to the salvation gift that you've given to us, Jesus. Let us not become complacent, Lord, but let us seek you and find you, Father, when we search for you with all of our heart, Lord Jesus. Thank you, Jesus.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Worship you this morning. You can go ahead and go be seated. We're going to get a couple of things we want to do, and then to share announcements and stuff. We're going to receive an offering. So let me just begin by welcoming to the house, back to the house, Pastors Manuel and Brandy Vizcarra, all the way up from Mexico. So praise God. I know he's got a great word to share with everybody this morning. Any other guests and visitors we have in the house this morning or watching at home, we welcome you to Elsinore Christian Center. If you're ever in town, we're at 104 South Kellogg in Lake Elsinore, California. Amen. So just a couple of quick announcements. Pastor Jim's live on Facebook on Tuesday nights at 7:30 throughout this month. You can find him in the ECC family and friends group. So tune into that if you would like. This Saturday, the time of prayer intercession here at the church, come by at 10 a.m. We're going to be right over here in the fellowship hall just to, again, pray for our city, pray for our state, our country, and all those things that need prayer now more than ever. Amen. So that's Saturday at 10 a.m. right here in the sanctuary. Let's see, on Saturday, July 24th, 8 a.m., the men's going to be having a breakfast over at the Landing Zone Cafe. I think that's over on Corydon and Grand is where it's at. So that's going to be on the 24th at 8 a.m. So men, mark your calendars for that. There are July calendars here also. If you haven't picked one up, make sure you get one of those on your way out today. Let's see. Just let everybody know the church is open for business. Okay. No restrictions on churches anymore here in California. So welcome back to church. So let's start filling the house back up and start shaking off those old cobwebs for being inside our houses, right? Amen. So with that, I think we're going to stand. We're going to bring our blessings to the Lord. Our regular tithes and offerings go right here in this basket, over in this box. It is Mission Sunday today, and we've got a couple of faithful missionaries and pastors right here with us this morning. So missions can go right into the box right here. So let's take our offering. Let's hold it up to the Lord, and let's just pray this prayer of thanks. So Father, in Jesus' name, Lord, we are so thankful, Father, that we can sow seed into your kingdom, Father. Lord, we're so thankful, Lord, that we can live in a country, Father, that allows us to give freely into the kingdom of God. So we just pray right now for every finances represented here this morning, Father. We just pray, Father, for increase, Father, for jobs and better jobs, Father. All those benefits, all those things, Lord, that we continue to believe you for, we just ask you to fulfill those needs, Father. And as we plant our seeds into the kingdom of God, Lord, your gospel is going to continue to go forward. And we're just so thankful. We praise you in Jesus' name. Amen. Regular tithes and offerings right there. Missions in the box. Hallelujah.
For me to admit, I got a fire inside and some words I know I can't keep in. I see faith turning into a show of Sundays and sermons and words getting caught in the flow. Oh, but we got real pain and real fears thirsting for the drying of our real tears. It's not satisfying anymore. Ain't it true?
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Here you go, Fred. Go ahead. Hallelujah. Amen. Amen. Well, it is a special Sunday today. Here it is, end of July, and we're just now going to be celebrating and honoring our high school FY graduates that are in the house this morning. We're so thankful for both of them. And also, our Sunday school kids are being promoted also. So we're just kind of celebrating our kids and our Sunday school. So with that, I think I'm going to ask Naomi and Julia to come on up here, you guys, so you can look at our two high school graduates, our FY graduates. I know y'all got all dressed up and everything. You got to stand over here, though. Don't stand over that way. You'll not be on the screen. So come over here. Okay, you got to stand here. This is Naomi and this is Julia. Okay. Both of them graduated high school this year. Naomi is going to be going to UCLA. And Julia is going to Mount San Jacinto College. So, okay, that could have changed since then. These guys change all the time. But we're here to just hold them up in prayer, just celebrate, again, their graduation with them. So, girls, you sit right there in the seats of honor right there, and we're going to show a little video. So kill those lights back there, if you could, whoever's back there. Anyone? Nobody's got the lights? Yeah, right there, John, right there.
Can't be
Hallelujah. All right. Come on up here, girls. That's one of the privileges we've had of you can go over this way, I guess. I guess you'll be in the video anyway. Because one of the reasons is because we've known these two since they were born. Yep. Okay. Which is very rare because we'll have them for 7 years. We've had them for 17, 18 years. So praise God for that. And that's why I had so many pictures. So and I had tons more. It's hard to choose all the pictures that we had. But just wanted to let you guys know that you both are been truly a blessing to Marie and I and to the church. And I'm just going to tell you guys, behave yourselves out there. Make good choices and keep God in the center of everything you do. Don't ever forget God. Don't ever forget your family here at Elsinore Christian Center, because it's a tough world out there. And we'll definitely be praying for you. Amen. So Marie's going to say something right here for
Well, Psalm 139, it's your book. It's both of your books. I'm just going to read a little passage from it. It says, "O Lord, you have searched me and know me. You know my sitting down and my rising up. You understand my thought afar off. You comprehend my path and my lying down and are acquainted with all my ways. For there is not a word in your tongue. But behold, the Lord, your God, knows it altogether. You have hedged me behind and before and laid your hand upon me. Such knowledge is too wonderful for me that I cannot comprehend." God's hedging, what that means is he is keeping you safe. He's before you. He's behind you. He's beside you all the way. And if we go down further, it says, "Where can I go from your spirit?" In verse 10, it says, "Even there your hands shall lead me and your right hand shall hold me." Doesn't matter where you're at, a bad place, a good place, a great place. He's always with you. So recognize he doesn't leave you. It's your choice to stay near him. It's your choice to put him in the center of all the activities that you do, and you'll be successful. And realize that, again, Joshua, verse 1 through 9, if you take all those verses, that was when God was actually changing and handing the baton or the mantle to Joshua from Moses to guide all the Israelites. He was a young man, and he's saying, "Now, Joshua, you're going to take over." And so now you're going to take over your lives. You've had everything taken care of for you, all the things you've been fed. Now it's your turn to take over. And what it says in there, God's telling him, don't be afraid. Have good courage. And know that he says that 365 times in the Bible. So we have that. Don't be afraid. Have good courage. I will take care of you. That is for us for every day of our lives, every day of the year. But what he says is, don't forget what I've taught you. Don't forget what I've said to you. If you listen to those things, I will lay the steps out for each day, for each thing you need to do. You won't have any question, and you'll be successful in all you do.
Hallelujah. Okay, Julie, here you go. That's for the church. There you go. That's for yours. Those are Starbucks gift cards from the church, so they'll be needing lots of Starbucks. Amen. Okay, Carol, can you come up here? We're going to just extend some prayer, cover these guys in prayer. And whenever the Lord puts them on your heart, make sure you pray for them. You got anything to say, Carol, to them?
Well, I'm going to come over here where I can put my hand on you. Yes. Amen. Father, I just thank you. I thank you, Lord, for these women, young women of God, Lord. Yes, Lord. Thank you, Father, that even before you formed them in the womb, Lord, that you had a purpose and a plan and a destiny for them. And so, God, I know that you're going to go before them. You're going to watch over them.
God, you are going to lead them. God, I just pray that you'll give them Christian fellowship, Christian friends, God. Yes, Lord. People, Lord, that will be a source of strength to them, Lord. And help them, God, even in their studies, Father, that they would become, Lord, all that you want them to be. Thank you, Father, for the families that are represented here today, God, that they have raised them, Lord, and showed them the ways of the Lord and the love that he has extended to them. So, God, they're just going to be an extension of that, even to those that they come in contact with. So bless them, God, and just keep them safe in your hands. And they are special to us, Lord. And as much as they are special to us, I know that they are special to you. So we thank you, Jesus, for this great accomplishment, Father. Lord. For both of them, Father, for the great accomplishment, God. And we just believe, God, that this is just the beginning. Just the beginning of all that you have for them. Amen.
Amen. Amen. And just to let you guys know, that it is a church's responsibility to continue to hold our kids up in prayer, whether they're 0 years old or they're 50 years old, 60 years old. We got to keep our kids in prayer. And that's what we do. We surround you guys with a hedge of protection and go with God and be blessed. In Jesus' name, we love you both so much. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. All right. Give them a hand. Naomi says those aren't real tattoos, in case you're wondering. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. All right. So that's what they should use nowadays. You want to get a tattoo, just get those stickers. It makes a lot more sense to me than any of that other stuff would. So praise God. Hallelujah. So those two are going to be a blessing to many, many people out there in the college land. So be a light, girls, be a light. Amen. All right. Hallelujah. We got a couple of very special people here this morning with us. They've been part of Elsinore Christian Center for as long as I can remember. Okay. I've been here for like over 30 years. So I've known for over 30 years. So they've been here even longer than that, since 1986 when the church first started. So they know everybody, and we love them, and they are pastors of a church down in Mexico, and I can't say the name. I won't even try to say the name. Okay, I've been down in the area one time, and I learned a lesson real fast. Don't take a van full of teenagers down to Mexico in an old van, especially the traffic jam, because they don't drive on the roads down there. They just drive anywhere they want. Are they still doing that? Just drive where they want, right? So it's like the Wild West as far as I can see. But Manuel and Brandy, they've been serving the Lord for many, many years now. And the church planted out of Rim down there. How many years ago has it been? 12 years ago, we planted that church down there. And I know they got some good news that they got what God's doing down there. But I just wanted to first read this scripture that the Lord put on my heart for you too. Okay? This is in Philemon. It says, I thank my God, making mention of you always in my prayers, hearing of your love and faith which you have toward the Lord Jesus and toward all the saints, that the sharing of your faith may become effective by the acknowledgement of every good thing which is in you in Christ Jesus. For we have great joy and consolation in your love, because the hearts of the saints have been refreshed by you, brother and sister. It doesn't say sister, but it's brother. So, Brandy and Manuel, give them a big hand as they come up. So, hallelujah. You want to stay on the floor?
No.
Okay, you got to climb?
Well, praise the Lord.
Amen.
What's the old saying? God is good
and all the time.
Amen. We actually say that in Spanish too. Well, this is a real blessing to be here, to be home.
Amen.
It really has. It's been a long run. We're pleased to be here. We're kind of missing our church right now because we know they're having service, and I feel kind of like a duck out of water right now because I'm usually up here. But I really enjoyed the worship. Matt,
amen.
Awesome. You are really awesome, dude. Awesome. It was very good. I love the songs. They were very touching. You people got to remember one thing. They're not just words. Take them to heart. What you're singing, God is hearing, and he wants it to come from here. And it was beautiful this morning, really beautiful. He's going to get to talk a lot, so I'm first. Yeah. Anyway. Right, honey?
Yeah.
Okay. Anyway, the church is growing down there. We're very blessed where we are in the area. Those that who have been there, Johnny and Lisa were just down there, praise God. And so they kind of got to see what's there. And, you know, we're hoping for more people to come and visit. We have a place where you can stay. So, and it's right on where we live, on the same street where the church is. It's In-N-Out Burger Street. Only one way in and one way out. So, yeah, if anybody wants to come down, they're more than welcome. Unfortunately, no vamos a estar hablando en inglés, puede español. And I know you don't understand what I just said, but anyway, but that's what you will get.
Only English, right?
Thank you. Carol, you're learning. Not even close. We are very blessed right now. We are going to be celebrating 12 years in October, which is amazing. I can't believe it. It feels like it went really fast. And I can imagine Jim and Carol kind of feel like, how did we get to how many years? Yeah. Yeah. Um, 36, isn't it? I thought it was 36. 86. Was it? Yeah, it was 86. Yeah, okay, yeah. Because we met the first day you guys showed up. 85? 35 years? Thank you. We need, don't leave. We we need help. We, like I said, we've been very blessed down there. We have a wonderful group of people. They love the Lord. A lot of activities, a lot of stuff going on. And just recently, my husband just got back from his second trip to a place called Chiapas in Mexico. And that is on the border of Guatemala. So all the way down to the end of Mexico. And we now have a mission down there. And it is a Rim Church. And we're very excited. The people are excited in the church over there. He couldn't say it, but the name of the church down there is El Camino de Jesucristo.
That's what I was thinking.
Yeah, I know you were. I know you were. I just was speaking it out for you, brother. Helping you out. And so they're very excited. Everybody's excited. The people down in Chiapas are very excited. Very sweet, very humble people. But the humidity is horrible. So I'm not going anytime soon. But we're really blessed. And we have some other people that have been talking to us, and they want to know about our church and our group. And so I don't know where this is going to lead, but it feels like God is opening up a door. So pray for us. Pray for what's going on down there, because right now we saw the door open wide for this little church down there. We'll see what happens. But anyway, we love you guys. We are blessed because we had a good start. We had a good start. And so we're... What can I say? You're all welcome to come down there. I'm still trying to bug a few people to move it, but to come down and visit. So if Mike can go to Mexico, come on. No, I do you one better. If Glenn can go.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. He went. So anyway.
You got it?
I got it.
He got it. Okay.
I always got it.
I do this every Sunday, but I got four steps.
Are you ready?
We are ready.
Yes. Very ready. You need to be ready.
Amen.
Don't get ready. Be ready. Because the one who say he will come, he will come. And you know who his name. Solomon saying in the Proverbs, he said, do you know God? Do you know his son? Do you know his name? He will come. And the day you don't expect, he will show up to take away from this world his church. Because this world, it doesn't deserve the church of Christ. It doesn't. You can read Hebrews 3:11. It will tell you right there. So, that's a kind of, I want you to open your Bible in 1 Peter 2:9. Think what you know from a long time ago. But sometimes we get caught up in things of this world, the duties of every day. Things where you don't expect it will show up. It will show up to hold you up, not to let you go. But you sing a song this morning, but who the sun set free, is free indeed. Even all of us, we've been set free by the blood of Jesus. But we still wonder sometimes where we are. I want you, Diana, you're reading English so everybody can hear it. Stand up and read it. Thank you, sister. I want you to know who you are. What God called you to be. Nobody called you but God. You need to answer the call of God. Because we have a dying world around us. Then they don't have hope. Because even starting from the government to the small one, put fear in your mind and your heart so you can go on in your life. Jesus Christ said, you are a chosen lineage. You are that? The Bible says, yes, if God says who you are, that's what you are. It doesn't matter who else say another thing. What is matter, what God's saying in his words, who you are. The Bible says that when you believe, do you come to be a child of God? Are you a child of God? Because you believe in him from the beginning. You believe in Jesus Christ. And you say, I receive you as my Savior. And he says, you are my child. But the thing is that this world has consuming us day by day and robbing us the identity, what God says we are. You are a chosen lineage, not from men, but from God. Are you that what God saying you are? The Bible doesn't lie. We believe in the lie around us, but God never lie. We used to believe in the lies of this world. You forgot that the devil came to rob, steal, and kill. And you have to take, you have been taken the lie in your life. What we're going to do? Pastor Jim said probably, what we're going to do now? The people want, they don't want to move on. They want to stay set. Who said that? God said, go, not stay. You not stay. You go. Because you have a dying world. Day by day, thousands and thousands of souls going to hell. And you and me, we are fine. Not. I have to tell you this because God says one thing and we believe in another thing. You are a priesthood, he said. Wow, I'm a priesthood. Who say that? Nobody told me that. Yes, Pastor told you every time and I remember. You are a priesthood. What the priesthood, what the priest does? Let me tell you what he does. What he do is to bring down the presence of God. That's what the priest do. And the Bible says you are a priesthood. There is in your house the presence of God flowing, telling you, the Holy Spirit telling you, it's time to get up and go on. I don't like that direction, Lord. You go or you don't. I like to be what God said, and I am. You have to have patience with me because my English is not very line up. But the word of God is line up to you. Because it says you are a holy nation. Are you? How holy you are. How dedicated you are for the Lord Jesus Christ. He says, you go. And we say, we stay. How that can be? Who you listen to? Well, I hear on the radio, I hear in the TV, I saw it, and this and this. But they are not God. They are false God. And Jesus commanded the disciples to go because he saw the dying world without hope and without faith. You are the children of God. You are the priesthood. You are a holy nation. You can deny that. At least we can get rid of that page from the Bible and say, no, my Bible doesn't have that. Wrong. Because it will still say, it doesn't matter, you take up the page. But I want you to know that God wants you to be used by his presence. He wants you to take, like he took Philip from the Gaza to Sodom and the presence of God. The Bible says that Enoch, he never saw him again. God wants you to transfer you to other place. Not from church. No, no, no. Don't hear me wrong. He wants you to put you to work. 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 I don't like work. I want to be retired already. Really? Let me tell you something. I don't think I want to be retired for my own will. Till God says, you are retired, come home, baby. Then when he take me home, I'm be retired. Well, not happen that, I'm not retired. Because there is a world, dying world waiting for the hope and faith. People who carry the Holy Spirit power on them, those people are waiting for you and for me to be saved from this generation, evil generation we have. You are people like God get God to himself. That's what he said. Un pueblo adquirido por Dios. People who belong to God. You don't belong to this world. Jesus said in John 17, you can read it the whole chapter if you want. You are mine, Jesus said. Sorry. You don't belong to this world. As I am not belong to this world, you're not either. But what we're gonna do, Pastor Mike and my brother, Bob, look at, I remember. Where are those who call, who used to say hallelujah and praise the Lord? Where they are? In fear, living outside in fear. They don't visit the church because, you know why? I don't want to get contaminated with the trash where the devil throw it to their face. But the government say this and this and this. The government is not your God. Who you trust? And why you don't work? Hello? Good morning, sisters and brothers. Do you think I don't want to be sitting in the couch with my margarita por un lado? I don't have margarita, I have brandy. So it's something there. You know what I mean. But what is most important for me? What are my priorities? What Jesus will say if he caught me in something weird? What we would say? I don't know, brother. He called you to announce the marvelous light to those who walk in darkness. I can go out, brothers. Pastor, I can go out. I can. The government said I can go. Wow. Somebody trusts in horses. Somebody trusts in chariots. But we will trust in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Wow. It amazed me. I can do all things in Christ who strengthened me. You use that scripture very often, but for your own convenience, not for the purpose of God. God wants you to get you out of the back and start to walk in like Peter on water. You have faith? Hello? You have faith. What is faith? Faith is the something what you don't see. The hope. Wow. I didn't know that way. Read the Bible more often. See, the problem is all these things take away what God says than we are. You sing the song too. I am what God says I am. But we don't believe it, we just sing it. We look like mockingbirds. We repeat what somebody else say it. ¿Verdad que sí, hermano? That's true, eh? Huh? You're not a mockingbird. You are the Son of God. You are children of the Most High God. You are not to imitate. You are real in Christ Jesus. But we need to take that position. God loves you so much that he gave his only begotten Son for the sake of your salvation. And then he said, go ye. Where? Anywhere. Anywhere who God called you to go. Your place is not earth. This is not your place. I mean, earth. It's not your place. You have lost your identity where you're going to. Jesus said in John 14, 1 to 3. No se turbe vuestro corazón. Don't trouble your heart. Ni tenga miedo. And don't be afraid. In my Father's house, there are many mansions there. You don't belong here. Jesus went to prepare a place for you. You are comfortable on this planet? You are? Guess what? Read the Bible, 2 Peter chapter 3. You will find out where this world is going to. Because we're expecting new heavens and new earth. You belong to here, to be here all the time, all your life till you're dead, you die. Where are you going? I'm going to heaven. Where is your reward? I don't know. Yes, you don't know because you did nothing for Jesus. You just received salvation. And well, I'm going to sit down and wait for Jesus. Guess what? You love Jesus, right? You really love him. I want to challenge you to see yourself if you really love Jesus. Who loved Jesus, give his life like he did for you. What are you going to do in Chiapas? Preach the word. There's many people dying there too. What are you going to do in Rosarito? I don't know. God will lead me to. And he lead me to. And what happened? Vaya a ver, go to see it. Brother John went to see what God had done over there. Brother Glenn, they went to see what God had done. Sister Carol, she's been there quite a time. I'm not saying you just go to Rosarito. No, go around the world where Jesus called you to go. Because around the world, you not even have in mind how many people die every day. And one day, one of us go. When Jesus doesn't come soon, we're going. But I know that the day I die, I have a place waiting for you, me. It is a place waiting for you too. Paul told the church, your citizenship is not here, it's in heaven, he said to the Philippians 3:20. I don't want to live over here. You sound like a Jehovah's Witness. You want to inherit on the earth. The Lord rebuked all those religions who come up from the ground because they are like a gophers. Come out of the holes and convince the world that they want to live here. No, I don't want. My place is ready to receive me up there. And for you too. Eh? So don't believe the lies. Don't believe the lies. I want you to go Exodus chapter 19, verse 5 and 6. And I want you, somebody read it. Brother Mike, you got a big voice. Exodus 19:5-6.
Now therefore, if you will indeed obey my voice and keep my covenant, then you shall be a special treasure to me above all people, for all the earth is mine. And you shall be to me a kingdom of priests and a holy nation. These are the words which you shall speak to the children of Israel.
You shall speak to them. Wow, it's awesome. Since times far away from us, God was saying who was his children. He knows who you are. He knows what you do. He knows what you think. Because he searched even the deepest of your heart. You follow me? No, I don't follow you. I follow Jesus. And you, I can say like Paul, follow me, because I'm following Jesus. That's what he said. He wrote in the epistle, follow me because I'm following Jesus. Who you following? Who you following? What is his name? Jesus. The Jesus where you have in the picture in the wall. No. That is not Jesus. Because you don't know Jesus. Do you know you don't know Jesus in person? Right? And why you believe in that picture? That is Jesus. Because that's what my parents say. That is Jesus. Who say? Your parent? Your parents not even was Christians. They not even believe in God. Atheists. Wow. Have patience with me. I keep going. Ephesians 2:19. Read it. Anyone. I want everybody to understand what the scripture said. Ephesians 2:19. Now therefore, you are no longer strangers and foreigners, but fellow citizens with the saints and members of the household of God. Do you know who you are now? You are a member of the household of God. Don't let the devil rob you who you are. Somebody make a movie, say the identity robber or something like that. It was special to rob the identity of the people. The devil is special to do that because he come to rob. That's what John 10:10 says. I don't say that. The Bible says that. The robber come to rob, steal, and kill. How many things he robbed from you already? I can number what he has robbing you day by day, the fellowship of the saints. First thing, you don't have fellowship with the people. They might have a COVID. And they get a COVID. The Lord rebuked the devil and them too. You know why? Because they believe more in the tragedy than the victories he Jesus gave to the people. You're going to Chiapas, hermano. Yes? There's a lot of COVID over there. Really? I'm not going by myself. The greatest is with me. It's Jesus. They call Jesus. And not Jesus, the neighbor. It's Jesus of Nazareth. No es Jesús el vecino, hermano. It's Jesus of Nazareth who come with me. If God is with me, who he is against me? You are full of afraid. I'm not going there. Pero si va al cine, si va al restaurante y come a sus anchas, si va a estos lugares, si va al otro lugar, si you go in places. You need to go where Jesus said you to go. Or you? Even the condition my wife is in, I'm not saying that she is dying, but I'm saying I went down there. The Bible said, who have wife like it, does he have it? Ay, no le puedo dejar sola a mi vieja. Why not? You don't born with her. Jesus calling you. The Holy Spirit is calling you. He say, come, come along. I will show you the place where you need to be. And you'll be growing like a weed in the ground. But hermano, isn't that that calling not for me? Really? The Bible says that those who are believers, Mark 16:17, and this sign, they will follow those who believe, and who believe what they believe in. They believe in Jesus. And this sign, it will follow them. Five signs, they will follow the Christians when they go. That's why nothing happened in the church lately, sister, because nobody go. Nobody go. We stay very comfortable. Yeah, I like the comfortable, please do. But I want to be where Jesus told me to be. It doesn't matter if I got stickers or whatever, or rain all over in the country. It doesn't matter. But Jesus, it's important what he's saying to you. He's saying, come along. I will place you in the place where you need to be. Well, not for me, that call. So you are not a believer then. But those who believe, they will lay hands on the sick and what? They will cast devils out and they go and they drink things, poison it, and drink it, and nothing happened to them. Wow. I want to be there. I want to be there. I want to get out of my comfort zone. You don't like it, that? Jesus called. He said the kingdom of God suffered violence, and only the violent take it. Wow. You love Jesus, huh? You start to find out how much you love him. Uh-huh. To say it is facile. It's easy, sister and brother. To say I love Jesus is easy. Like the baby start to learn to talk. But when you step out in faith, you will see the waves rising next to you. But you have to act like a Peter. You want me to go, Lord? Come. You have faith? Make a first step, and he will carry you wherever he wants to carry you. Wow. Thank you for giving me the whole day. You're not hungry. You have breakfast in the morning, right? I'm just warning. Estoy calentando los motores apenas. I'm just warming up. I'm not giving the message yet. How long you can stay in a service who takes 2 or 3 hours of preaching, learning, and eating? You're not that big, like you say. Oh, I was small too, and I grew. And guess what happened? Jesus said, go. And we say, yes, Lord, we will go. We will go. You have to answer God too. Do you know that, huh? God wants you to go. When you go up there and show up with him, he wants you to carry something for him. Fruit. Not fruit from the store. John chapter 15. He said, and I want you to bear fruit, and fruit abundantly. Where are you looking right now? Where are your eyes put on? Where they are? Your eyes, where they are. Supposed to be in Jesus. Because he said, he is the author and finisher of your faith. If your eyes are on Jesus, you never gonna fail. You're never gonna sink in your life. Because the powerful hands of God, it will be there for you when you doubt. Why you doubt, Peter? Man of little faith. But because we all started in that way, little faith. But when you have how many years a Christian? Hello? Hello? How you do? Oh, my faith is starting to grow. Wow. Put fertilizing. Put the word of God in it. Because faith comes by hearing the hearing of the word of God. If I ask you, how many times you read the Bible in the day? You are broke, completely broke. One time a week? No, it's every day. It's the bread for your soul. You can live without it. You can live without the word of God. It's the bread of life. Jesus said in John 6, he said, who eat this bread, he will never have hunger again. Never. But we like to eat what the world says. We eat everything. It's like we eat in junk food. You don't get nothing in your body. You're just junk. You like the Coke with the with the chips, potato chip, right, huh? You love it. You know, eat a plate of beans. And they will make you better than the chip and the coke. Because they have protein. Frijoles, huh? You have resurrected with Christ. You sure your eyes be up there. You, because that's what the believers are. Resurrect with Christ. Paul said in Romans chapter 6, you resurrect with Christ, you will live with Christ. You don't resurrect with Christ, guess what? We don't want to hear it. Huh? I love it. You know why? Because I'm sharing you something what you need to hear every day. The Holy Spirit is talking every day to the Christian. Every day you pray, he's talking to you. You read the word, he's talking to you. You fellowship with a brother, he's talking to you. You go in and be a witness, he's talking to you. Well, you don't want to talk with God? He's the only one worthy to have a conversation. All the rest is part of this life. But he is the one. Paul said to the Ephesians chapter 5, verse 1, be imitators of God like a beloved children. You imitate God, or you don't know where you are, or somebody stole your identity. You don't know if you believe or not. I don't know. I don't know if I go to church. The church is almost nobody there. If you miss it, you're going to be less. The devil robbed you, the fellowship of the saints. He's robbing you, they constantly robbing you the fellowship of the saints. And sometimes you feel like you don't care. Tomorrow never comes. Because you were involved in other things. And what you do? You're forgetting your priorities. Jesus must be your first priority. If not, he's coming when you don't think he will come. And you will be left behind. And you don't want to feel the sense in your mind and your whole body that Jesus came and you didn't know. Because if you watching TV and you seeing that the thousands and millions of people disappear from planet Earth, guess what? You just left behind because you're watching it. They disappear and you not. Isn't that sad? Isn't it sad? Just to think, it made me not. No, you want, what you want me to do, Lord? Hey, I want to keep myself busy with you. One day I thought about it, my little dog that I have. And I was thinking, I look at my little dog, Chihuahua, probably Johnny saw it. And I see, I love my little doggy. And I say, Lord, when you come, the dog is going to be left behind. Many people think that the dog is in heaven. Read the Bible. We love the animals. We love it. It's part of this life. And I say, you're going to leave behind. Come on, my boxy. Come on. Is that too bad? You're going to be left behind when Jesus comes? That terrorized me. That the dog would be left behind. How much myself? You don't fear God? Go on with your life. But I remind you one time, you will remember. And that crazy guy who came to the Elsinore Christian Center and told us and Jesus were coming, and I ignored it. Good for you. Because you're gonna go through that great tribulation. And God have mercy of you. The church is supposed to be filled up like it used to be, all the way over there, all this, but nobody work for it. Hello? And how do you know, brother? When I don't work, God doesn't work. I have to work. Jesus said, my Father work, that's all I am. We work together. Fill the chairs. There is many people outside dying. And you don't tell them about Jesus. Invite to the church. The preacher going to church is with him, with them. Yes, invite it. The 90% of the church is because somebody invited them and stay in the church, hearing the word of God. And they change. They get transformed. But you don't care the souls, huh? You don't care for them. Mm-mm. Because if you care, all the empty chairs will fill up. How you think the pastor will like to see the church full completely of people, the new people, if we were jumping around. This is the church of Jesus Christ who has revival in their hearts. And they want the sinners get saved. That's revival. Sometimes you expect the revival to come, the pastor invites the preacher, the evangelist, and he comes, and he takes the revival with him. You notice that, huh? Or you haven't seen that? How many years we've been here with Pastor Jim? Many years. There's a girl who wasn't born, not even in the plan for the parents to have the children. Pastor Jim bring people to have a kind of a little move. What happened? The preacher take the revival with him and leave and the church again. That's why the revival have to be starting in your heart. In your heart. When we start revival over here, it can go nowhere. But growing and growing and growing. And people will come. You hear that sound, that saying, if you build it, they will come. Huh? Well, if you preach here outside, they will come. The only way where the church will fill up. tell Pastor Jim, Pastor, I'm going to the street looking for souls. Go. Don't be afraid. God didn't ever give you a spirit of fear. No. But the power and sound mind. Ho ho. Sometimes we allow the people, Emmanuel, brother, not to make long service because they're not used to. Get used to. Because when you go to heaven and not be 1 hour service, it will be for eternity. And what are you going to do? ¿Me entiende? You understand that? Get used to. With the pastor take an hour and a half preaching, enjoy it. Enjoy it. That not happen anywhere. They're shorting and shorting the service. Why? Make it longer. Who is with you is going to stay. And those who leave, they're not yours. Let it go. I told them, though, the people in the church. Pastor, I'm going to move to another church. Go. I bless you. Go. I'm not asking why is he going. No, no, no. Because I know the faces. When I see their faces, I know everything what he's going to tell me. Go. I bless you. Go find the church when you can fit. You're not going to tell me to stay. No. But you tell me, you just told me that you're leaving. Bye. Bye, sister. Bye, brother. I love them dearly because I pray for them every day. But they don't love me. They don't belong to me. You don't hear that very often. People try to bring people to them for the money. They call dollar, they call the green. Why they call the green? Because the dollars are green, huh? I guess. They are green? You guys use dollars. They are green or they are red? Are you sure they are green? They're kind of between brown and green and you not even know what color they are. Because you just get it from the packet and give it to the store. Not even watch what you're doing. It doesn't matter how many people you have. What is matter is the those that you have, they working for Jesus. Because they are who going up. And the day with Jesus coming. The rest, they're going to leave behind. They like the world. They're going to stay in the world. I love you, brothers and sisters. I love you. And because I love you, I'm telling you this. You, it's necessary for you to work for Jesus. For you, for who are you working now? Ya mero nos vamos. I almost done. I just need, I think, 1 hour more. Yeah. Really? You gonna take that long? You remember when you was in the in your parties before you come to Christ? You stay all night. And the say what you was saying is, why is it done so early? You remember? Or you forgot? No, I don't forget that. Why so early? There are 4 in the morning. And the party is going the next day. And why you stop it so early? We keep going. We like to keep going. Well, this party is the real one. Go on. It doesn't matter how you get to the... Mira, hermano. Can I go down, sister? It doesn't matter if they don't see me. I want you to see Jesus. Jesus is the important one. I'm not worth not even a penny, probably, according to people. But Jesus is worth all. You understand? He loves you, fellowshipping with the brothers. He loves you to the time to read the Bible. He loves you to come and pray. I don't know how long you're praying over here, but the most I can, I pray in the church. Why? I need pray. And people pray for me too. I'm not only to pray for them, they need to pray for me. Because I got the batuka, I got a torch in my hand. I have to carry on. They have to push me, spiritually speaking. Think how many things the devil have robbed you. And that's why we are, Michael. That's why we are like we are. What we gonna do? I don't know. But I think I barely, Pastor Jim barely paid the bill. Barely. And maybe he have to put out his packet to complete the bill because there's no one in the church. Those who are here, they do it. But where they are, the other ones? Where did the rest? You know? Think. The pastor needs your protection, your covering. If you don't pray for him, you always expect the pastor to pray for you. No, it works both sides, both ways. If not, I would not be here. Somebody called me, Pastor, I wasn't at the church today, but I'm praying for you. Good for you. Because I need it. You and me, we need it. The Bible is rich in wisdom, knowledge, understanding, everything you ask. Here. You don't have it because you don't open it. Open it. And patient. Patient. And you will see the treasure you're going to find in here. You're not mad with me, huh? I love you. I love you. If not, I would not be here. Trust me. I'm not going with Elsinore. They hate me, everybody. Everybody throw me a rock, if that is possible. But I know you love me. Jesus said to the people, come one and say, and he looked down there. Nathaniel, who was under the tree. And he said, when he came, he said, this is the real Israelite. This is the real one. And Nathaniel said, yo, we can say that in our own language. I am a real Israelite. When you were under the tree, I love you. I know you who you are. What kind of tree you are under? Jesus loves you very much. No matter what going through, you going through life, his love is everlasting love. He never failed to you. You sing the songs, all those kind of songs, and you love it. Practice. Practícalos, hermano. Practícalos en tu vida, en tu corazón, que se llene de esas alabanzas. The Bible said, sing a new song to the Lord. Sing it. Maybe you're going to start to speak in tongues. You don't know why you're talking about it, but you speak in tongues. God wants to hear you, from you, a new song from your lips. What are you going to do? Sing a new song. We always sing the songs of somebody else. Huh? Good. Because we're not writers. We're not writers, you know why? Because you don't surrender the Holy Spirit. Those who know to write, they sing in the presence of God. That's why they know how to write a song. Sing a new song in tongues. Why don't you speak in tongues, brother? Well, tell the Holy Spirit to give it to you. He will give it to you. Ask and you shall receive. You don't receive because you don't ask. We are so good like that. Sitting down so quiet. That's telling me you're not a Pentecostal. You know that? Hello? Hello, brothers and sisters. Are you a Pentecostal or are you somebody else? Pentecostal jump in the presence of God, speak in tongue, prophesy. The spirit of the prophecies get up in you when you are available to him. That's why you need to come and pray in the house of God. Come and pray in the house of God. God, the devil has robbed you the time to come to the house of God and pray. You want to keep letting it? No, es que me duele el pie. Mi esposa va así caminando por las piedras allá para llegar a la iglesia con el bordón, pero va a la oración. She's going to pray anyway. Why? Because she knows she needs it. I can pray for her, but she needs to pray for herself. And you? How many? No, don't tell me. How many people come to pray at church? No time, sister. No time, Diana. It's true, no time. You gotta make time. Acomoda las cosas. Fix things around so you can have time. Dear Pastor Jim, I'm so glad he invited me for this time. Because the word of God comes when it's needed. Rebecca, you need that? You need to hear that? But you hear me love you so much. I do too. We partners in crime. And you know what? It work. It work. So stand up. My brother Mike, God bless you and thank you for here to be here.
I just want to say one thing. Somebody told you about Jesus, and you gave your life to him. Don't you think we need to pass it on? God asks us for a couple of things. First, he called us to be saved. But he also called us to do the work. You know Christ is coming soon. There's no doubt in that. We don't know what soon is, but my point of view, it's soon. And the Bible says one thing. When Jesus comes, he wants to find us doing the work. He wants to find us doing, not sitting, not thinking about it, but getting up and doing it. And I don't know about you, but the first thing that comes to my mind and in my heart is I want to please Jesus, not man. I want to please him because he did it all for us. Amen. We're here. We're alive. We have a life because he wanted us to be born. So don't you think that he had a plan for us? So the best thing we can do for him is tell others about him and to be found doing when he comes. Amen.
Hallelujah. Stay right there, Brandy. Timely word of exhortation and mixed with a little encouragement. Amen. Extend your hand towards these faithful servants and let's just pray for them. Father, in Jesus' name, Father, we just thank you for these faithful servants, Father, these pastors you've called, Father, do great things for your kingdom, Lord. And we just pray right now, Father, first for a strengthening and encouragement, Father. Lord, the things that you're doing in the church in Mexico, Lord, but now even this new opportunity down in Chiapas, Father. Lord, we just pray, Lord, you begin to open those doors that need to be opened, Lord, and close the doors that need to be closed, Father. But we just speak of peace, Father, over Manuel and Brandy, Father, a strengthening, Lord, even as they go back home today or tomorrow, whenever it is, Lord. But we just ask, Lord, that you just continue to bless them, Lord. Continue, Lord, to put them on our hearts, Father, so we remember to pray and lift them up in prayer, Father, so they can continue to do the work that you've called them to do. But we just ask blessings on them, blessings on all those here this morning, those that are watching from home. We just ask blessings on the rest of this day. In Jesus' name, amen. Hallelujah. Make sure you guys come up and greet Manuel and Brandy. I'm sure they're glad to talk to you. So have a great week.